Hey, my kings and queens, it's your girl Destiny Dynasty, and I'm back with a hit it. All right, you guys, I just wanted to say that before we get into this video, because I already know y'all read the title, just give it a big thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, show your girl some love. You could comment, give me some tips, give me some, if you didn't like it, give some comments, let me know that you didn't like it, what could I do better. You know, I'm all open to good and bad feedback, you know? I want y'all to communicate with me so I can do better content to keep y'all entertained. If you have any recipes that you would like me to try, I am open to it. So just comment down below and let me know. I hope you enjoy this video because I did and my family did. Enjoy, my kings and queens. Hey, my kings and queens. Today, you are cooking with Destiny. We are making baked ziti for the family on Family Sunday. We got our ground beef already in the pan. We have everything we need. We got our fresh garlic, adobo, onion powder, and some accent. It's the off-brand of Sazon. It works just the same. All right, I got my meat already in the pan. I turned the fire on, and I'm grounding it up a little bit before I start to add my seasonings. I already put a little bit of accent in it already. Now I'm adding my fresh garlic into the pan as well. That was just like a teaspoon and a half that I added. I didn't want to put too much because I'm out of seasoning. There's some adobo, you know. Put your own seasoning, whatever you feel like you want to season your meat the way you want it to taste. Then I'm going to add some onion powder in it as well. And then another pack of accent. I put two packs of accents inside of my meat. So after you get all your seasoning in, you make sure it's nice and salty to your feel. You also start your boiled water. I got my little helper, Leah. And you put a little bit of oil inside your water. And turn it on so it can start to boil as you brown your meat. My seasonings is in the meat. I'm going to start to brown it as my water starts to boil. Now that my meat is getting brown and my water starts to boil, I'm going to add my noodles pretty soon. And soon I'm going to add the sauce, start doing my sauce. So my noodles I'm going to start adding into the pot because it's already starting to boil. I use penne noodles. You can use the noodles of your desire. I can find ziti noodles, so I'm using penne noodles. I'm using 2.5 boxes. It depends on the serving of how many people you're going to cook for. So after I put the noodles in the pot, I stir it around a little. I'm going to stir it around because I don't want the noodles to stick. So, 2.5 boxes of noodles, get you a spoon and mix it around so that your noodles is not sticking together so that it can start to cook while you docker up your meat with your sauce. I docker my sauce because, you know, I got to put my own splizzle on it. You got to put your own thing on it. I don't want it just to taste like tomato sauce. I want it to have some flavor. So, my meat is brown. Let's get into doing the sauce. Everybody got different ways of doing their sauce. I put tomato sauce with the traditional, and then I use the garlic and herb. I use 1 and 1 I put in a pan. I only use 2 when I put in a pan of the meat. I like to use 2 inside the pan with the meat, and then I use some more when I'm putting it all together. So my meat is cooked. Now it's time to turn off the fire and add my sauce. I'm sorry, guys. So I'm going to add the traditional one. And then I'm going to add the one thing, a mushroom. You know how you get the sauce stuck at the bottom, like after you empty it all out? You either put a little bit of water, put the top on, shake it up to get the little sauce out, or just put the top back on and flip it upside down because I like to get all my sauce, all my money worth. Okay, baby? All right, put that mushroom, garlic, and herb. Put that right up in there. Sometimes I put onions and peppers inside my ground beef, but my family didn't want that this time. Also, you can use any meat that you desire, but I'm going to use ground beef because my family do not eat pork. Sometimes I use Italian sausages. Sometimes I use ground turkey. It's the meat that you desire. But this time we're going to do, the regular degular. We're doing some ground beef. So I'm mixing the sauce up into it. I'm adding some more seasoning, some adobo, some garlic powder this time instead of the fresh garlic because I already put that inside the meat. We're gonna add some more, a little bit of onion powder. You don't want to season it too much because you already seasoned your meat. But you do want your sauce to have flavor. So I didn't have any basil or no parsley. That's what I usually put in it too this time. So and then my magic sugar. You can't make pasta without a little sugar. I mean, you can, but I like my to have a little sweet. My family like it with a little sweet too. So you add you a little bit of sugar if you like your pasta sweet. A little sweet, not super sweet. You want it to mix together, the sweet and the salty together. It's so good. Just a little hint of it. Now you mix it around. I turn my fire back on low so my sauce could be cooking into the meat so the meat could taste it at every bite. So you got that mixing around. Let it sizzle. Let it sit for a little bit. Now we got to check on our pasta. Mix that around again. Because the pasta's not quite done yet. You gotta mix it around. Making sure everything is cooking equally. Want your noodles to be nice and tender. You don't want it to be soggy though, because it gotta go in the oven. Now that your noodle's done, you make sure you strain it real good, get all the water off. Do not put any cold water on it because you do not want to shock your noodles. These noodles are going right back in the oven. You do not want to shock them. So you just strain all the water out of them completely, and then you get ready for the next step. The next step is when you're putting everything together. Well, the next step is the ricotta cheese. We have to do our ricotta cheese. Some people just put, the ricotta in the thing. No, you gotta crack that egg so your stomach won't hurt, your family's stomachs won't hurt. Crack one egg. And add your ricotta cheese. Make sure you don't got no shells in there. You don't want nobody to have no crunchy, crunchy ziti. So add your ricotta cheese in it. I'm using two ricotta cheeses because I had got the smaller ones. They did not have the big ricotta cheese like I usually use. So you add your two into the bowl with the egg, and you get you a whisk. I didn't have a whisk, but I used one of the things off the blender. So after I add both my ricotta cheese, I mixed it around real good. You make sure you mix it around. This is where I add my parsley and my basil, but I did not have it this time. So I add my parsley and my basil inside my ricotta cheese, which you can if you have it, or some cilantro. You mix it in, mix the egg in real good, and if you have the basil or the parsley, you can add it in and you mix it in real good all together. Make it look all pretty. Mix it, 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 until it's nice and creamy and you don't see any yellow. Then you add that ricotta cheese into your meat sauce. The fire is off now. You add it into your meat sauce. Make sure you get every drip out the bowl. Like I said, you want to get your money's worth. You didn't pay money for these ingredients just to wash them down the sink. So you after you add it into your pan, make sure you get every inch of it. Then we're gonna get us a nice spoon and we're gonna mix it into our meat sauce. Mix it real good. Mix it. Mix it real good. Mix it. Mix it real good. I like to mix it until it's all nice and creamy. You're gonna see what it's gonna look like after I'm done mixing it. So let me show you. See? Looks nice and good. That's our meat sauce. Our meat sauce is done seasoned. Now we got our cheeses, our Mexican cheese, our mozzarella, and our noodles, and our meat sauce. So you start off with the noodles. I already coated my pan. put some noodles, a layer of noodles. Sometimes I put the sauce, a layer of regular sauce without the meat sauce at the bottom first. But this time I'm not. I'm going to put the noodles in first. Make sure you spread it all in every corner of the pan. You start off with a little bit because you're layering it. This is the layering process before you put it in the oven. This is you prepping your pan of ziti. You put the noodles in, spread them around. You know, they might be a little hot. That's why I'm using a spoon and I'm using my hand. I don't want to burn myself because the noodles is hot. They just came out of boiling water. All right, and then I take my regular sauce, my traditional or my mushroom sauce, whichever one you decide to do. I like to put a little drizzle on it first because I don't want it to be dry because it has to go back in the oven. Then you add your meat sauce. I know you're like, why are you adding that sauce if you put your meat sauce? Because the meat sauce has the ricotta cheese in it, and I don't want it to be dry. I want it to be nice and moist because remember, I'm adding cheese as well. You layer it now with the meat sauce on top of the noodles and the regular sauce. Add the meat sauce, the nice, good mixture with the seasoning, the sugar, the onions, the garlic. You know, add that meat sauce onto there. Add it. I'm sorry, y'all. I had to sneeze. All right. And then you add some mozzarella cheese, your cheese mixture. You put the cheese on the top. Put the cheese on the top. My family like their pasta cheesy, so we add a lot of cheese. That's why I got 3 bags of cheese. You put you some mozzarella. Then you put a layer of Mexican-style cheese. Like I said, get the cheese that you want, whatever you like to make your stuff cheesy with. And then, you know, we repeat the process over and over and over again. Again, your noodles, your regular sauce, your meat sauce, then your cheese. You just keep repeating until you get to your final layer. I'm doing a voiceover because my background was loud. So we add the final layer. You add all your noodles that you have to the fire, the that's left to the final layer. You spread them out to every corner is covered and it's even because you want everybody to get that even amount of everything, even amount of meat, even amount of noodles, even amount of sauce and cheese. You have to make sure it's even. We put the final layer of noodles. Now we got to put the final layer of meat sauce. This is the top. On the top layer, I like to put the noodles, then the meat sauce, then the cheese, and then a little bit of the regular sauce because I do not want it to be dry. I want it to be nice and moist and delicious. I want it to be so good, and I want everybody to enjoy it and not have no dry, crunchy, oh, I need a glass of water meal. No. So you put your meat sauce and you make sure you get every corner. I like to go around the perimeter first because, like I said, you need to have everything covered. And if you get the corners real good, it's going to start to go down into the bottom, into the other layers, and it's going to be so good. So, yeah. So make sure you get your perimeter and then you fill in the top. You make sure everything is covered. Look at that nice, that meat. You see the meat? Everything has meat. Got the sauce. Got it looking good. Make sure you cover the whole thing. So that's the final layer of the meat sauce. And now, you know, what's next? The mozzarella cheese and the Mexican cheese. You cover it. Got my last of my cheese. You cover the whole thing. Make sure you get every corner so that everybody could get a nice cheesy bite. You know, you cut it and it's going to be so cheesy. You just make sure you cover the whole thing. My family loves cheese. If it's not enough cheese, trust me, they're going to say something. So I make sure I put enough cheese all over it. After I put the mozzarella, you know I gotta put the Mexican because you can't go wrong. You gotta put the blend. You like the different taste. It gives it a nice mix. You cover the whole thing, every corner. Make sure everything is covered. I know you like that's a lot of cheese. You can never have a lot of cheese. I love cheese. cover the whole thing with the cheese. Yes, yes, yes. All right. And now my oven is already prepped. I already had it prepped on 350. So now I'm going to cover it with some aluminum foil after I put on my original sauce. Remember, I told you have to add a little bit of it. I'm sorry. I know y'all saw me having a little weak moment, but your girl, you know, she got her muscles up there. The muscles is like deep within. So add the sauce onto the top, just a little bit. I know you're like, ooh, it look like a pizza now. Oh, add my aluminum foil onto my pan, and I put it into the oven for a good 25 minutes covered. And then I, you know, I'm going to show you when I take the aluminum foil off. So now I'm boiling my water for my corn on the cob. My family and I wanted corn on the cob because the salad at the store was not looking too good. So we're going to have corn on the cob and garlic bread with this meal today. So I got my water boiling. I'm taking my ziti out because soon it's going to be time to put it back in the oven without the top on it. So in the meantime, while it's still in the oven, we're going to do the garlic bread. Get it nice and prep that Texas toast, baby. Looking all good and buttery and garlicky. Start putting that corn in that hot boiling water. You already know. I'm about to chef it up. My family is about to eat well tonight. I'm just saying. You welcome to come to Sunday dinner. Just let me know when you want to come to Sunday dinner. It's a lot of us eating tonight. So I gotta do a lot of corn. Huh, now this meal, I put my heart, sweat, and tears in this. It was hot in that house with the heat on and the oven on. You know how that be. It be so hot. But I had to do my thing. Now it's time to check this ZD, you guys. Let's see what it's looking like. Let's see if your girl, you know, did it. Is it a bop or not? That's the question. Let's see if it's a bop. Let's see the masterpiece. Ready? Here we go. Here we go. Ready? Oh. Look at that cheese. Nice and melted. Oh, my gosh. But, you know, we got to put it back in the oven for a good 10 minutes. Put it in the oven for another 10 minutes so it could get a little crisp at the top. You don't want to put it in no longer than another 10 minutes because you do not want your ziti to be dry. Whew, y'all see that corn in that stove boiling? Now you have to take it out and let it stand for a nice good 10 minutes. Oh my gosh, look at that masterpiece. When you make this at home for your family, make sure you tell them that your girl hooked you up. Your girl hooked you up and told you the secret to making some good baked ziti. Now let's look at the dinner. Dinner is served. You got your corn on the cob with the butter garlic all over. Butter garlic all over. Destiny made her own butter garlic. Look at that garlic bread and that ziti. The girl did her thing. I had to lay it out right. I had to lay it out right for my family. And you know you got to end it right with a nice family prayer before you get into this meal. My family is excited. They ready to eat. They came hungry with their appetite. I hope you use this for your family. I hope y'all enjoy the video. Failing out things, I'm working for my good. Cause he's intentional. He's intentional. Hey, and he's never failing. All things are working for my good. Intentional.